sound in the mouth changes at different angles. The two angles are 90 degrees and 45 degrees. Also, our inquiry is based upon the different sound frequencies when the mug has different water temperatures, hot water and cold water. Before we begin an investigation, we need to know the variables. The independent variable is the variable that we change. Archie, what's the independent variable?
The temperature of the water inside the mug.
Perfect. What is the dependent variable? The dependent variable is the one that you measure.
The frequency of the sound produced when you hit the mug with a pen.
Perfect. What are the control variables?
So the type of pen we use is going to be the same. The type of mug we are going to use is going to be the same. The position of the vernier microphone and the water level. These are the things we are going to keep constant.
The arrow of a mug, the blue arrows indicate 90 degrees, whereas the green arrow indicate 45 degrees. Our hypothesis states that when we hit the mug with a pen, the frequency of 90 degrees is going to be lower than the frequency of 45 degrees. Let's find out. So now we're choosing one, then we go to insert, we go to additional graphs, we go to FFT graph. Here we have the graph with frequency on the x-axis and amplitude on the y-axis. As you can see, the more dominant one, the more dominant harmonics are on this side. So the frequency is approximately 1250 or 1300 hertz. This graph, as you can see, has major dominant harmonics in this area between 2000 and 3000 Hz. So we can say that the frequency for 45 degrees is about 2500 Hz. Now we're going to inquire whether different temperatures of the water impact the sound frequency of the mug. The two temperatures are 60 degrees Celsius and 5 degrees Celsius. So this is 200 ml of hot water, which is 60 degrees Celsius. This is the trial for 90 degrees. As we can see, the frequency for 90 degrees with hot water actually increased from 1300 before to around 3200 hertz now. Water at 5 degrees Celsius with 90 degrees. The frequency of cold water is 1350 hertz with 90 degree angle. The frequency for cold water at 500 degrees is about 2100 hertz.
Throughout our investigation, we first observed that the frequency at 90 degrees was lower than the frequency at 45 degrees. A possible explanation could be that if you hit the mug with the pen, it will vibrate. This then makes the air vibrate, which you hear as sound. When you hit the mug opposite, the handle will form into a slight oval because you've squashed it. So the mug will then rebound and form an oval at 90 degrees, as you can see in the diagram on the screen. Although we can hear the difference in pitch, this happens far too fast to see. Whereas in 45 degrees, a similar thing happens, but with the oval at 45 degrees now. This means that the handle doesn't have to be moved by the vibration, so it doesn't affect it in the same way if the mug had to move the handle at 90 degrees. At 90 degrees, the mug rang at a lower pitch than when it was at 45 degrees. We also know that the frequency of sound decreases when it enters a denser medium. In this case, the medium stays the same. However, unlike 45 degrees, the handle also vibrates as 90 degrees, making that part heavier and denser, which makes the particles travel slower for vibration. Therefore, the data points show that the frequency at 90 degrees was 200 Hz, whereas frequency at 45 degrees was lesser, as you can see in the Google sheet. Now, we wanted to further investigate if the temperature of water affected the frequency of sound at both the angles. Our hypothesis stated that the higher the temperature, the higher the frequency. As shown in the data points, this was true for both the cases. We can see that at both 45 degrees and 90 degrees, the frequency with hot water increased. Tapping a pen against the mug with boiling water produced a higher pitch sound than tapping the pen against the mug with ice water. The speed of sound in water increases with increasing water temperature. High frequency sounds travel faster than low frequency sounds. In cold water, the molecules carry less energy and are less excited, meaning it's more viscous. This means that the water molecules move more slowly and they're more likely to stick together. This creates a lower frequency sound. Hot water, on the other hand, produces a higher pitch sound when poured because the energized molecules are moving around more rapidly. This has a higher frequency. This explanation is just our thinking using our knowledge of waves and sound. This can be further researched. One of the problems we encountered during the investigation was the challenge to calculate the frequency. We used Logger Pro and we could hear the difference in the pitch, but we needed a way to show it with quantitative data. Therefore, we used the FFT graph which displayed the amplitude and frequency graph for us. In order to make our results more reliable in the future, we can take more trials and make sure that we mark the point for 45 degrees and 90 degrees. We can also explore this topic further by observing the difference in frequency when the material of the mugs is different or calculating the frequency of the mug without the handle. Overall, this investigation taught us the change in frequencies of sound at different angles and at different temperatures of water.